What's up?
Urea is a product of ammonia detoxification. Urea is produced in the liver in urea cycle from two ammonia molecules and carbon dioxide. So to explain this, there is intestine, there is blood compartment, there is liver and kidneys. So when we consume proteins, in the duodenum, proteins are degraded by digestive enzymes into amino acids. Most of amino acids are absorbed into the blood and carried to the liver. In the liver, amino acids undergo deamination that results in production of ammonia molecules. Then liver, by urea cycle, makes from two ammonia molecules and carbon dioxide a urea molecule. But the small amount of amino acids in the intestine are not absorbed. They are delivered to the colon, where bacteria deaminate them with formation of ammonia. Then ammonia molecules diffuse into the blood where they are uptaken by the liver. Liver converts them in the urea cycle into the urea. And then urea molecule is excreted into the blood and delivered to the kidneys, where kidneys excrete urea molecule from the organism into the urine. In Europe, we determine the amount of whole urea molecules in the blood. And in normal state, the concentration of urea in the blood is between 2 and 8 millimoles per liter. But in USA for assessment, use blood urea nitrogen. Basically, it's just nitrogen molecules in structure of urea molecule. And the normal value of blood urea nitrogen is between 5 to 20 milligrams per deciliter. So urea and blood urea nitrogen are not the same thing, but every time when urea is elevated, blood urea nitrogen is also elevated.
I like it. Simple, easy to remember.
So first of all, why liver converts ammonia into the urea? The concept is that ammonia molecules are nonpolar, and because they do not have charge, they easily cross through the barriers, including blood-brain barrier. And ammonia molecules can cause damage to the brain tissue that results in hepatic encephalopathy. And also because ammonia molecules are nonpolar, we cannot excrete ammonia into the urine. So to solve this problem, liver from ammonia molecules and carbon dioxide makes a urea molecule. And urea molecule is much more polar. First of all, as polar substance, it cannot cross through the barriers. And also because as polar substance, kidneys can excrete urea into the urine. So basically, liver with one conversion solves two crucial problems.
This is either madness or brains.
It's remarkable how often those two traits coincide.
Actually, to simplify this pathway, we can say that the level of urea in the blood is maintained by urea production, which is determined by the amount of ammonia molecules and the function of the liver tissue, and urea excretion, which is determined by the kidneys. So why the concentration of urea or blood urea nitrogen can increase? First of all, it's possible if kidneys weren't able to excrete urea molecules from the blood into the urine, which is the case in kidney injury. So if kidneys are damaged, their capacity to excrete urea molecules decrease. So the income of urea molecules is the same, but the excretion of urea molecules decrease. As a result, the urea level in the blood begins to progressively increase and becomes greater than 8 millimoles per liter or greater than 20 milligrams per deciliter. Another reason is increase in urea production. The first factor is increase in consumption of protein-rich food. The more proteins we eat, the more amino acids we get, the more ammonia molecules are formed. The higher the income of ammonia molecules to the liver, the more urea molecules liver will produce. The second factor is increasing amount of bacteria in the colon, which is the case in dysbacteriosis. If the amount of colonic bacteria increase, then more proteins will undergo deamination. As a result, the more ammonia molecules will be formed. The higher the income of ammonia molecules to the liver, the more urea molecules liver will produce. But how to tell such increase in urea is caused by kidney's dysfunction or by increase in ammonia production? For this purpose, we used to determine the concentration of urea in combination with creatinine. Creatinine is also excreted by the kidneys. So if kidneys work fine, then excretion of urea and creatinine will be normal. In this case, because the income of ammonia molecules to the liver is high, the production of urea molecules is elevated. As a result, blood urea level will be elevated. But in case of kidney dysfunction, kidneys are not able to excrete urea. But also kidneys cannot excrete creatinine. As a result, the level of both urea and creatinine in the blood increase.
Now, as long as you're just hanging there, pay attention. The only rules that really matter are these. What a man can do, and what a man can't do.
What if we see urea or blood urea nitrogen level lower than normal? The most common cause is liver dysfunction. Because in case of liver injury, liver is not working properly. So the uptake of ammonia molecules decrease and also urea cycle is not working. And without urea cycle, we cannot convert ammonia molecules into the urea. So urea level will decrease, so it will be lower than 2 mmol per liter for urea and lower than 5 mg per deciliter for blood urea nitrogen. But what is by far more dangerous is increase in blood ammonia level, because high ammonia level will cause hepatic encephalopathy. Another reason is low urea level caused by decreasing protein consumption, which is quite rare and usually occurs in alcoholics. Because with decreasing protein intake, there is less amino acids. With decreasing amino acids, deamination decrease, and thereby ammonia formation decrease. And with decreasing ammonia income, liver production of urea decrease.
Okay, fine.
Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao.
It's Italian. It means food.